Hey guys, welcome back to K-World for the third and fourth episode's recap of the K-drama link. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to the video. The episode begins with Gayoung dreaming of his childhood. His class has a tradition of sharing letters with their friends. Gayoung usually gets more letters than others, and his sister would tease him for that. After his sister disappears, Gayoung gets comfort letters from his entire class. But he tears all the letters, except for the one from his sister, and a letter from Ui-chun's son confessing that on the day Gayoung disappeared, he saw his father Ui-chun in blood. Ui-chun was Gayoung's piano tutor, and so he became a prime suspect. Gayoung watches as he gets taken into police custody. So does Ui-chun's son. Gayoung finds it difficult to sleep after the dream, so he goes back to his restaurant. Da-hyun in the meantime sneaks into his restaurant to check the refrigerator. When Gayoung gets there, he is surprised to see the door unlocked. He finds Da-hyun standing by the refrigerator. Gayoung silently watches as she checks the fridge and asks her if she found what she was looking for. Da-hyun stammers that she saw the door open as she was passing and came in to check. Even though Gayoung knows she's lying, he lets her leave. But he tells her that he might be on her side. While wondering what Da-hyun was looking for, Gayoung feels as someone is watching him. Gayoung decides to move to the upper floor of his restaurant while leaving his aunt with his mother. Jingoo checks to the window and realizes that he has a clear view of Da-hyun's room from Gayoung's living area. Jingoo wonders if Gayoung really is her stalker. At the breakfast table, Da-hyun tells her mother and grandmother that she checked the refrigerator the other night, and it was empty. Even though Bok-hee beat her up for going alone, the three wonders if Gayoung moved the body. As Min-jo and Won-tuk patrol the area, they notice Da-hyun, Bok-hee, and Chan-ok hiding on seeing them. And they become suspicious of the three. They get informed of a potential domestic violence report. The two officers go to check, and Jae-suk answers the door saying it's a false alarm, and that she's living alone. Just as she closes the door, they hear a glass break. Min-jo decides to check, but Jae-suk stops them. Chung-soo, who is Jae-suk's husband, comes to check to ask if Jae-suk called for the police. Won-tuk is protective when Chung-soo gets too close to Min-jo. Min-jo visits Bok-hee's restaurant for a meal, but she's just keeping an eye on the three women. Yoon-jung, who is another customer, shows Bok-hee a photo of Jin-joon as she pays her bill. Apparently, Jin-joon is her brother, and she's looking for him since he's out of reach. On her way out, she sees Da-hyun, and we see on the day Jin-joon gets killed, he gets a call from an unsaved number which Da-hyun answers and quickly hang up. The call is from Yoon-jung. She sees the photos of Da-hyun as she goes through Jin-joon's social media account. She intentionally bumps into Da-hyun and talks friendly to her. Won-tuk sees Da-hyun on his way and tries to get her to talk. Gayoung senses her uneasiness on his way and sees Da-hyun with Won-tuk. Gayoung thinks that he's the man assaulting Da-hyun and quickly comes to her aid, grabbing Won-tuk by the collar. Da-hyun calms both the men, assuring that Won-tuk is a police officer, and Gayoung misjudged the situation. Da-hyun gets curious about why Gayoung keeps interfering with her affairs, asking if he thinks such acts would win her heart. In relief, and to her surprise, Gayoung tells her that he plans to treat her well, but warns her not to develop feelings for him. That night, Da-hyun dreams about Jin-joon chasing her again. Gayoung also wakes up sweating because of her nightmare. So both of them go to grab some alcohol to help them sleep, and meet on their way. Gayoung offers to make her a snack, and the two end up drinking together. Days pass by, and Da-hyun continues to come to Gayoung's restaurant in the middle of the night, until it becomes a habit. Da-hyun finally asks him why he's been nice to her. Thinking of his sister, Gayoung tells her that he's treating her the way he couldn't do to someone he cared. While dining together at the police station, Min-jo brings up the decayed body, and it is murder as per the autopsy. When Min-jo shows interest in the case, other officers argue that it's not under their unit. Young-hwan angrily reminds him of Ui-chun, the prime suspect in Gayoung's case, and suggests that he might be the primary suspect in this case as well. They had to let him go, because back then there wasn't enough evidence. Ui-chun now lives as a homeless person in the neighborhood. On noticing it's raining, Jin-ho brings up that he saw Da-hyun leaving the house without an umbrella. Gayoung remembers his sister also forgets to take an umbrella, and he had to wait for her in the rain. Da-hyun reluctantly decides to go back home, covering herself with her bag. As she runs, Gayoung appears with an umbrella, claiming he was nearby and saw her running. But she notices the other umbrella he has brought with him. Because it is broken, they end up sharing the same umbrella. While hanging out, Bok-hee and other women of the neighborhood brings up the recent murder that happened in the neighborhood Da-hyun used to live in. They remark that Da-hyun getting fired from her workplace is a blessing in disguise, because she moved out of that neighborhood just in time. Offended, Bok-hee tells them that she didn't get fired, but quit to do something big. At the restaurant, she urges Da-hyun to study hard and pass the civil exam she is preparing herself for. Da-hyun finally breaks down and tells her that she is not confident enough to take the exam, and that she lied to her about her previous job and the salary, because she didn't want to upset her. Da-hyun tearfully tells her that she doesn't want to live her life for Bok-hee, and wants to start doing things she like. When she storms out of the restaurant, she finds Gye-hoon already waiting for her. He invites her to his restaurant to eat something. But Da-hyun asks Gye-hoon to hire her. Jin-ho on the other hand takes two samples of Gye-hoon and Da-hyun for a DNA test. When Da-hyun gets to the job interview, she finds Yoon-jung already being interviewed as a chef. With Gye-hoon's permission, Da-hyun tells Yoon-jung that she works there. Bok-hee is frustrated by her daughter working in a restaurant right in front of her own. Chan-ok urges her to leave Da-hyun alone, and drags her to the dancing lessons, since it will be good for her stress. The lessons are done by Jae-suk. While everyone is dancing, she approaches Bok-hee and Chan-ok, and asks them if they could kill someone for her. She then confesses that she witnessed everything that happened on the day Jin-jun was killed. Stunned, Bok-hee and Chan-ok watch her as she continues with her lessons as if nothing happened. The two women notice her bruises and conclude that she is being abused by her husband. Da-hyun on the other hand has a late night snack with Gye-hoon as usual. Da-hyun gets carried away, and decides to tell Gye-hoon that she has developed feelings for him, but on seeing the refrigerator, she tells him that she killed a person. On realizing what she just said, Da-hyun starts laughing saying it was a joke. Gye-hoon worryingly asks her who else knows about this other than him. Even though Da-hyun tries to convince him that it was a lie, Gye-hoon warns her to be careful, not to talk about it, or else it'll be just a matter of time before she'll be exposed. Da-hyun takes the advice the wrong way and threatens him, saying she is willing to kill him if he exposes her. That night, Gye-hoon dreams of his sister and Da-hyun, admitting that they killed a person. Da-hyun as well as have a hard time sleeping, since she admitted to the person she has a crush on that she is a murderer, and even threatened to kill him if necessary. When returning to her room, after drinking some water, Da-hyun overhears Bok-hee and Chan-ok planning to kill people who are threatening. They agree Da-hyun should not know about it. The next day, Gye-hoon realizes that Da-hyun and her family were obsessed with the refrigerator, and remember that he felt Da-hyun's fear on the day Jin-jun was killed. He nervously opens the refrigerator, and gets startled by Jin-ho when he arrives. He wonders if Jin-ho moved the body. Later that day, Da-hyun meets with her former employer So-jung. She tells her that Jin-jun disappeared after Da-hyun claimed him to be a stalker. Yoon-jung has stopped by the office asking for him. So-jung warns her that she seems like a crazy person. Yoon-jung spots Da-hyun heading back to the restaurant. She quickly puts up a smiling face and tags along with her, saying they will be working together after all. On the first day of work, Gye-hoon hands both Yoon-jung and Da-hyun the manuals of the restaurant. But they are surprised to learn that Gye-hoon still haven't come up with a name and the opening day of the restaurant. Gye-hoon allows Yoon-jung to use their knives as she wants, and on hearing about knives, Jin-ho remembers that one of Gye-hoon's limited edition knives went missing. Sun-hwa, a resident of the neighborhood, finds a knife, which is the missing knife from Gye-hoon's collection, in her husband Min-chul's belongings. Jin-ho receives the test results of the DNA test. He makes Gye-hoon walk with him to the car, and asks him if the reason he moved to this neighborhood is to find his lost sister. Gye-hoon admits that he is looking for someone, but it's not his sister. Wee-chun, who has been watching him, asks Gye-hoon if he came back to kill him. Gye-hoon angrily says to him that he will kill Wee-chun the moment he has the evidence to prove Wee-chun killed his sister. They get interrupted by Jung-ho. He takes Wee-chun with him, and warns Gye-hoon that he's watching him. While patrolling, Min-jo and Won-tuk get asked to check on a drunken man. They find out the drunken man is Chung-soo. When Chung-soo gets physical with Min-jo, Won-tuk tries to interfere, but Min-jo quickly interrupts. In the meantime, Jae-suk meets with Bok-hee and Chun-ok. She confesses to her husband's aggressiveness. When asked why she hasn't reported him to the police, Jae-suk admits that she is frightened that he will be released and will come after her and her family. She apologizes and brings up Da-hyun and forces them to help her to get rid of Chung-soo. Da-hyun helps out Gye-hoon as he works in his greenhouse. Since the restaurant is not open yet and she has been hired as a waitress, she got nothing else to do but help Gye-hoon. Meanwhile, Bok-hee and Chun-ok talk through Jae-suk's threat. Even though Chun-ok tells her daughter to calm down, she herself can't, and finally gives in and storms out to kill Chung-soo. Da-hyun sees her mother trying to stop Chun-ok, and runs after them. Gye-hoon sees the three women, and go after them as well. In a dark alley, Won-tuk intentionally runs into Chung-soo and beats him up. Gye-hoon goes around the neighborhood looking for the three women, and stumbles onto Won-tuk. He recognizes him and notices his bloodied hands. Chun-ok, Bok-hee, and Da-hyun find Chung-soo already beaten up. As they get close, the police arrive and they assume they assaulted Chung-soo, judging by the weapons they carry. Jin-ho sees the three women get taken to the police station. Min-jo interrogates them to find the reason for the assault, even though they protest that it wasn't their doing. Gye-hoon and Jin-ho also rush into the police station. Chung-soo, on the other hand, refuses to tell anything about the attacker. So the police talk to the person who reported the assault, and according to him the attacker was a tall male, and was wearing black clothes. Gye-hoon realizes the attacker is Won-tuk. On their way back, Bok-hee and Chun-ok notice Yoon-jung waiting outside Gye-hoon's restaurant. After returning Gye-hoon's shovel, the three women heads back in. Da-hyun learns about Bok-hee and Chun-ok being hired as killers by Jae-suk. the three women have a sentimental moment together. Yoon Jung notices Gye-hoon crying and laughing for no reason, and wonders what's wrong with him. Later, Jin-ho shows Gye-hoon the DNA test dress, and that Gye-hoon and Da-hyun are not related. Gye-hoon lent out his anger on Jin-ho. He then admits that he knew all along that Da-hyun is not Gye-young, but was fooling himself thinking she might be her. He wanted his family and him to be happy again like they used to be. Yoon Jung and Da-hyun decide to hang out. Yoon Jung becomes curious about whom Da-hyun is dating. Da-hyun admits that she's not seeing anyone but thinks of Gye-hoon. On seeing her change, Yoon Jung thinks that she's thinking about Jin-joon. Da-hyun tells her that even though she doesn't clearly remember her childhood, she remembers a boy who always came to her rescue when she was in danger. She thinks that the boy had a crush on her. But apparently, she's remembering Gye-hoon, and Da-hyun was one of Gye-young's friends. She just misjudged the situation thinking that Gye-hoon came to her aid when he was there for his sister. Da-hyun then asks about Yoon Jung if she has someone she misses. She admits she does, and we see her crying every night because she misses Jin-joon. Da-hyun stops by Gye-hoon's restaurant on her way back. But Gye-hoon treats her coldly and decides to leave. Da-hyun confronts him with a sudden change. Gye-hoon tells her that he decided to stop being nice to her, since he doesn't want her to get the wrong idea. That night, while cleaning, Gye-hoon thinks over his missing knife and the missing body. He tries to distract himself from thinking about it, but finally gives in and asks Jin-ho when he noticed the knife was missing. So he decides to tell the news to Da-hyun. Da-hyun also decides to meet with him since she can't get over their last conversation. Gye-hoon asks to let him talk first when they meet. Da-hyun was hoping for him to apologize and give her permission to have feelings for him. But to her disappointment, he tells her that he thinks Jin-joon is still alive. We then see on the day of the incident, Jin-joon waking up in the refrigerator. He takes a knife from Gye-hoon's collection and storms to Da-hyun's house. But as he crosses the road, he gets hit by Min-chul's taxi. Even though Da-hyun is disappointed, she thanks Gye-hoon for telling her. As the episode ends, Jin-joon appears from nowhere and starts choking Da-hyun, while Gye-hoon watches them in shock. That's it for this video guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it and see you next time.